For relatedly, this is ano naman po yung ginawa niyo po sa Binondo, the China Bank, for its 100th year. Can you share your experience and what did your team do for it?
Well, what is ideal there is this. China Bank, when they celebrated their 100 years, wanted to glorify their presence in Binondo, no? And when they hired, and one, there is the sensitivity coming from management pertaining to their legacy. That's important, diba? That they're not just saying, okay, we're 100 years and therefore let's celebrate. No, they wanted to show that their 100 years has a rich heritage and a rich legacy, particularly in the built heritage side. Now, of course, you have to give kudos to the management, particularly Mr. Hans C., for having that vision of, highlighting and having a sensitivity to their history, okay? Now, when they hired me now, the brief was basically to restore the building back to its original 1920s look. And fortunately, or sabihin natin, unfortunately, they don't have any materials available except for some archival photographs, which were malabo pa to begin with. The building didn't have any, shall we say, historical plans. So I had to undertake what I would call architectural archaeology to find out what is happening with the building. So two sides, you have the physical architectural archaeology side and the second is the structural side. So dun nagkaroon ng syempre dalawang usapan ngayon, because you'd want to keep the building safe and they want to keep the building operational for another 100 years. So with that statement coming from them, kasi that they want to keep the building for another 100 years, that showed now that they are committed to preserving and conserving. So any case, yun na nangyari. And what we did basically first and foremost was we did an as-built plan. An as-built is basically you come up with the plan of the building as it is now. Okay. And then we did a lot of investigation, looking for details, looking for elements. We had to crawl through tiny cracks so that we could find design elements. Kasi nga, ang meron kami, picture lang eh. Hindi namin alam kung anong ginawa nila at nangyari na itong picture na to. And that's a big gap. And there are no living people who could tell us. Fortunately enough, when we were doing our investigation, we were able to see some peaking of the historical arches that were hidden by a marble clad. Kasi ang nangyari naman kasi is that the ground floor all the way to the second floor was cladded in solid marble. Yung taas walang problema eh, because kita mo naman sa labas eh kung ano itsura. No? There was no addition except for changing the windows and pagkain ng aircon, yung mga ganun-ganun. Pero all of the changes occurred sa ground floor. So, and that's what's crucial, because yun ang eleganteng side. You have the arches, the arcades, the grill work. My greatest fear was that I can easily replicate the arcades and the arches, but I may not be replicating the grill work, because if there were no samples of the grills, I don't know how it looks like. I'm basing it on a vague picture that's so pixelated if you blow it up that you cannot, But then when we were investigating, lo and behold, elements of the grill work started emerging. And then when we finally started clearing some offices and doing certain demolition, goodness gracious, lumitaw yung grills. Ang ginawa lang pala, tinakpan. So all of these are surprises that not even the building occupants or management knew. And we had to, I was fortunate enough that when we started peeling the layers, there were layers that were peeled. Mahirap kasi nagpipiling ka, wala naman palang mapipil, diba? Ito, may lumitaw. And that served now as the basis. And it was just a matter of retrieval. It was just a matter of consolidation. And it was just a matter of eventually enhancing. And applying new strategies to the reality of the building. And one of the things that we did was we removed the mezzanine, and we now exposed the very stately 6-meter-high floor to ceiling of the interiors of the building. We were able to bring back the original, small lang as it may be, the original lobby, as well with the 6-meter-high ceiling, restored the original 1930s elevator. So it's done meticulously. It was done scientifically. It was done with a lot of careful studying and heart, basically. Trabaho ko lang is restoring the building and bringing it back to its
original. How long po did it take?
Well, it started in 2018, the discussion. Actually, prior to that, it started around 2016 with the discussion. But it's the contract was signed 2018, and that's when we officially began. And it took one whole year just to document the whole building. It cannot be done simply because, as I said, there's structural concern. We had to do vibration tests and so forth and so on. We had to trace all of the wires isa sila pumupunta. And compounded by that was the fact that there is another building beside it that is umbilically attached to them. And that other building is not significant. So how do you separate the two? Parang ganon. So that took about a year until around 2019. And then from 2019 onwards was supposed to be the construction. But while we were doing the construction all the way up from March of, or February of 2019 when the demolition began, all the way to around January of 2020 when we were able to start the countdown celebrations, then we had the pandemic. And that literally put everything to a standstill. And the timeline for the building now became a little bit more delayed simply because parabang there was no more rush to finish it on time, brought about by this situation that we are experiencing.